Hey you guys, what's up? So I'm still continuing my mission to do a commentary on every single Marvel movie in the MCU at least. And I already did my Avengers one, so this one is the next one after that. Why am I even telling you guys that? You already know that, right? Don't you? Iron Man 3. Now, I have a very strange love-hate relationship with this movie. I mean, well, I didn't exactly see it all the way through the first time I saw it. It's a very long story. I kind of saw it on a friend's phone in a car somewhere. It's a very long story. Maybe one day I'll get to it. But basically, I saw about an hour plus of the movie, and I kind of liked it. I really enjoyed myself. But then we had to cut this thing short, and we had to go, and I had to wait a few days until we could finish it. So basically he gave me his phone a few days later, and he let me watch the rest of the movie. And of course then that big twist happens, if you know what I mean, if you've seen this movie before, and I already bet you have. And I was not happy with it. I did not enjoy that twist at all, and I hated this movie for a very long time. But then again, every time I watch this movie again, yeah, not really much of it. Not so much I wanted to, is more of a, I watched it as part of a, like I'm doing right now, watching all these movies before the next one comes out. The more I see this movie, I kind of get what they were going for, and I kind of like it a bit more. But then again, that ridiculous twist at the end kind of bothers me. So we'll see. Maybe having seen a few other movies with Iron Man in it since the last time I've seen this movie, maybe it'll change my mind, I guess. And I basically talked to some people who kind of managed to slightly made me shift my opinion as far as the twist goes, but I don't know. I'll need to watch this movie again to really reevaluate my opinion as far as that goes. So, Iron Man 3, starring Robert Downey Jr., directed by Shane Black, not Jon Favreau, as opposed to the other two movies. So, let's just hit the play button.
All good movies start with a black screen.
What a great way to start the movie. Staying true to the character of Tony Stark. I love the narration too, because if you watch this movie all the way to the end, you know who exactly is he talking to. It's not us. By the way, I love this song. I absolutely love this song. Again, the Paramount logo still showing up for some reason. 1999. Bern, Switzerland. New Year's Eve, duh. Happy Hogan with long hair. 90s Jon Favreau. He looks weird, but he actually looks good. Oh, look, there's Jensen! So they knew each other before the cave thing? You know who I am! You can tell already that this movie's being directed by Shane Black. I mean, this has his style all over it. And then there's this guy. Nerd! Man, Guy Pearce looks completely unrecognizable in this world. And he's wearing an AIM t-shirt. AIM, by the way, is a massive organization in the comics, run by this floating head guy with little arms and legs. And I love AIM in the comics and the video games. I mean, when I heard AIM was in this movie, I lost my mind. I literally thought we were gonna see MODOK. And of course, what happens happens. One of the many reasons why I had this really love-hate relationship with this movie, because I love what it was setting up for, did not enjoy at all what it ended up being. Well, that's a bit unusual. By the way, I don't know if you can tell, but there's a definite shift in the quality of the picture. That's because this is the first Marvel movie that was shot with this brand new camera that they used after they switched to Disney. Not Y2K. I guess there goes the plan. And he's still waiting on the roof. One of the many reasons people are still comparing this movie to The Incredibles, by the way. The movie literally starts with a prologue of the hero, you know, disrespecting a fan, and the fan becoming the villain. Yeah, those were good times. Oh, Rebecca Hall, man. After a brief soiree in an Afghan cave, I said goodbye to the party scene. Forgot the night in Switzerland. Friend, hey, man. Mostly. I'm an Avenger! You know who I am. Dance. Man, he got, and look at this, he wipes the injuries completely off. It's Dummy again from the first movies. Oh, he's got that thing from Arrow. Yeesh. All the other Iron Man armors before this movie. So he's been working on over 40, 30 plus armors since the Avengers, by the way. Which ties into how the Avengers ended, because he travel to space, basically. Oh, look, the peanuts. And once a guy travels to space, you know, it changes your whole perspective on life. Naturally. That was an awesome idea, by the way. Not a really big fan of the execution there. To have a armor that literally just flies to you. Alright, I think we got the cinema. And as you can see, it doesn't really work all that well. Oh! Not the best looking armor in the, out of all of them, but still a nice feature. Sleep! I'm the best. And blah! That's the piece that flew there earlier. I like his shirt, by the way. The Ten Rings again! You remember those guys, by the way. Hold on a second. You terrorist. I consider myself a teacher. America. Ready for another lesson.
Sand Creek, Colorado, the U.S. military waited till the friendly Cheyenne Braves had all gone hunting, waited to attack and slaughter the families left behind, and Clay.
Now I've got 10 rings of my own.
39 hours ago, Ali al-Salam Air Base in Kuwait was attacked. I did that. A quaint military church filled with wives and children. Soldiers were out on the maneuvers. The Braves were away. President Ellis, he continued to resist my attempts to educate you, sir. And now you've missed me again. You know who I am. You don't
know where I am. And you'll never see me coming.
Man, that was such a good idea at first! I mean, this is the frickin' Mandarin! The greatest Iron Man villain of all time! And he was reduced into... Sorry, I get upset about this. Oh look, there's Rhodey. He's got a new Captain America paint job. That's the closest thing we're ever going to see to a Tony Stark being Batman. Again, Rhodey still has that ring. That could have been a twist in the movie. He could have been part of the Ten Rings all along. The Rocketeer! No, that's Iron Man flying through the wormhole. By the way, this is the first movie taking place after the Avengers, so the world is still shocked that these people still exist. That's not the right thing to ask a person! But, you know, kids are kids. And did he literally just have that thing parked there? Out in the open? No sign of cardiac anomaly or unusual brain activity. It's no surprise. My diagnosis is that you've experienced a severe anxiety attack. Again, this is one of the many ways, this movie could have gone in such a better direction than it did. Because he's still having PTSD from fighting aliens. And the Mandarin is based in alien technology. So why would you take that away from him? This makes zero sense. I'm sorry, you guys. Kind of losing it. Yep, it is. Since you've taken the post, you've had a rise in staff complaints of 300%. Huh? It's not a compliment. It's not a compliment. It is a compliment. Clearly somebody's trying to hide something. Excuse me. At least John Favreau's got a lot more to do now. Since he doesn't have to direct himself in the movie. And, I mean, you can't really fault Shane Black for the performances. I mean, the number one job of a director is to get the best performances out of the actors, and he clearly does that. Oops. You cleaned up good. What?
Merry Christmas. After years dodging the president's ban on moral biotech research.
Moral, yeah. AIM, by the way. I haven't read the Extremis comic book, by the way, but I doubt it has anything to do with the plot of this movie, from what I've heard about it.
Wait, hold on, that's the universe, my bad, but
that's... Some Shane Black humor, clearly well placed. Literally.
It's a live feed. Come on up and prove it to you.
Because you saw him put something behind his ear. That was the feed device thing. Again, I love the holographic technology in the Iron Man movies. The pain receptors.
Primary somatosensory cortex. It's the brain's pain center.
And that's what I said. Who came up with that stupid idea? Frobzis.
Hello? Is this Forehead of Security? What?
Forehead of Security! Whoa, that's a lot of drinks. All the other, armors. By the way, he created this whole Iron Legion as a response team for aliens after the Avengers incident. Apples. It's a simple button! What happened to his hand? You punch somebody? And this guy doesn't hear you at all, right? The Super Friends! That's a DC thing. Years ago.
Turned me down. Something tells me now there's a new genius on the throne who doesn't have to answer to Tony anymore. And who has slightly less of an ego.
It's gonna be an Al Aldrich. As much as I'd like to help you.
No? That's not a very good line. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Slow down there. Happy, 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 happy.
Yes, I just, God, I forgot my...
The thing. But he can still work on iPhone, okay. The giant bunny thing. How do you even get it there? Hello there. No. By the way, he actually brought that technology back in a Spider-Man Homecoming. Controlling, remote controlling the armor. Massage with an Iron Man armor. Crowbar. Oh, no, wait. As you can clearly see, he very much bulked up for this role after the other movies. This is pretty much the only movie you're ever going to see him this jacked, by the way. Yeah, quick bite. What?
Were you checking up on me? No, you're fine with me. I'm going to bed.
Come on. Hey, I admit it. My fault. Sorry. I'm a piping hot mess.
At least he admits it.
Going on for a while. I haven't said anything.
I believe this is 6 months after the Avengers. At all.
You experience things. When they're over and you still can't explain them. Gods, aliens, other dimensions, I'm just a mannequin. The only reason I haven't cracked up is probably because you moved in. Which is great. I love you. I'm lucky. But honey, I can't sleep. You go to bed, I come down here, I do what I know. I tinker. Threat is imminent.
They're,
machines.
Pardon me.
A distraction.
Maybe.
You're welcome to join me.
You're going to join me.
Does he actually shower with that thing? Oh, look, flashbackness. I saw that movie. I really love the PTSD angle. It's a shame they went away from it after this movie.
Down.
It keeps falling apart. Yeah, because you got the technology in your forearm. Seriously, what happened to his hand? I don't remember anything in particular. Oh look, the Chinese theater. Just in case you didn't know, Disney bought this franchise by now. This guy again. Because people usually do that. Or that! What exactly was he planning to do with that?
How you doing, buddy? Got by yourself? Little date night? See your favorite chick with me?
Yeah.
A little movie called The Party's Over, starring you and your junkie girlfriend. Here's the ticket.
No kidding. That doesn't belong to you.
Oh, really? Now where have I seen that before? Panic and run! Panic and run! You cannot be helped. Pizzuts! Gotta admit, using the extremists to turn people into living bombs was actually a pretty good idea, first. Now look, a bunch of people got vaporized and somehow Happy was, I'm not gonna say unharmed, but still alive. And he's pointing in that direction, believing that somebody's gonna find his body and realize what he's pointing at. So is that useful for their condition, or is that just a random candy that he put in his mouth? Now, here's an interesting thing. That attack on that Chinese theater was completely unplanned. And yet... They... I did not know that. Hey!
My disciples just destroyed another cheap American knockoff. The Chinese theater, Mr. President. I know this must be getting frustrating, but this season of terror is drawing to a close. And don't worry, the big one is coming. Your graduation.
That they went there. Why didn't they stick with it? Anyway, they just managed to put a mistake into a success, which I love that. Actually, a bunch of really good actors came from that show. Willie James and Dan Stevens.
We're awaiting you by the up 20 Stark. We're hoping he'll give us the reaction. His reaction to the latest attack.
If you watch closely, one of these guys has a very old phone. I think this guy. And look at that. Yep, was able to upgrade it into a completely different phone. Now watch this, he's got his glasses on in this shot.
I've been wanting to send to the Mandarin. I just didn't know how to phrase it until now.
No glasses here.
My name is Tony Stark and I'm not afraid of you. I know you're a coward. So I've decided.
And now he's taking him off.
I'm gonna come get the body. There's no politics here, it's just good old fashioned revenge. There's no Pentagon, it's just you and me. I'm the off chance for a man. Here's my home address.
Oh boy.
10880
Malibu Point.
9265. I'll leave the door unlocked. That's what you want to
do. Smash! That was not a very wise thing to do, by the way. Give people his home address. And again, I love the way that they set it up, because how they became enemies. I wish they would have just stuck with this storyline and not throw it in a completely different direction. Because I love this, and I'm getting angry because I know what comes next. So after 3 miles, there was bomb parts. Bazoong! Again, I'm a huge fan of this holographic technology! I love it! I wish this technology actually existed! Uh-huh.
Tennessee?
What are the odds? Again, this... Again, this just shows you just how smart Tony Stark is. Yeesh. And she suddenly decided to show up again. And in record timing, too. Bazing! By the way, there was, in the script, there was originally plans for her to be the Mandarin all along. And then, of course, they changed it to whoever it was. Not much anymore. Old botanist pal. Barely. Please don't tell me there's a 12-year-old kid waiting in the car that I've never met.
He's 13. No, what? I need your help.
What for?
Why now? Because I read the papers, and frankly, I don't think you'll last the week.
Okay, fine. Sorry. Yeah, he fought aliens, by the way. And a god.
No, not really. It was just one night.
Yep. Rebecca Hall is a beautiful woman, by the way. Hey!
We're going out of town.
Okay, we've been through this? Nope.
Yeah.
The man says no.
Immediately and indefinitely.
Funny, great idea.
Let's go.
I'm sorry, that's a terrible idea. Please don't touch your bags.
This is how normal people behave.
I can't protect you out there.
Is that normal? Sadly,
yes, this is normal.
Oh,
normal. Be funny, relax about it.
Meanwhile, we come on. Split second reflexes. By the way, just in case you were wondering, in the comics, Pepper Potts did have an Iron Man suit of her own called Rescue. This is a little bit of a nod to that. Oh, well, look, it's that annoying guy again. The first time I saw this, I literally thought he actually was planning to put the armor on himself and missed. And then this happened and I realized, oh, he was protecting her. Which again, I love that! He's always putting Pepper before himself! That's how much this guy's changed since the first Iron Man. I guess fighting aliens would do that to you, huh? Stop stopping. Yeah, she doesn't know how to use that yet. Kaboom! Itself.
Jarvis, where's my flight power?
Lucky no, it's this is a prototype.
It is? I thought it was fully functional. Everything's offline now. Take this!
Thank you.
And another one down, and another one down. Kamikaze! This is a wonderful action scene, by the way. I can't believe I haven't acknowledged it yet. When you think about all the moving parts and the way he's making split-second decisions in the middle of a building that's falling apart, being attacked by helicopters with missiles. This thing is great. So this movie's not all that bad. It's just, you know. Well, you know. I wonder if he built another water suit by now. Because he has that in the comics. It's definitely not this one, but I'm just wondering if he actually built one in the movies. And look, a great big action scene. The hero was on top at one point, and he failed. Again, brilliant storytelling. It's just, I'm gonna just stop talking about it. Wait, what's? Oh, that's the bunny. Bye bye. It still annoys me. I hate seeing people chew with their mouths open. Yeah, what do you think he's been doing? So basically Jarvis saved him, not him. Oh, finally. So he was asleep the whole time. Uh-oh. It's a great scream. I'm surprised this thing hasn't fallen apart yet. Buzz.
Stone, right? Where are we, upstate?
We are 5 miles outside of Rose Hill, Tennessee.
Why? Jarvis? Not my idea. What are we doing here? This is thousands of miles away. I gotta get Pepper.
I prepared a flight plan. This was the location.
Technically, he did kind of ask them to go to Tennessee.
Maybe I'll just cozy back up for high. I think I need to sleep out, sir.
Jarvis.
Since when does Jarvis need to sleep?
Jarvis? Don't leave me, buddy.
I guess that's giving Jarvis a bit of humanity. You know, in the comics, Jarvis was originally Tony Stark's butler, a real live person. But in this movie universe, they decided that was a little bit old-fashioned and probably a little too much like Batman. So they made him an AI. Oh, so by the way, Speaking of Batman, everyone knows that Tony Stark is basically a ripoff of Batman. Batman's butler, Alfred Pennyworth, his father is named Jarvis Pennyworth. So, by the way, just in case you didn't know, the acronym for Jarvis is just a rather very intelligent system. Just saying. He just found a random house and decided to break in there. It is freezing outside here. Harley Keener, played by Ty Simpkin, the guy from Jurassic World, by the way. This thing. And he doesn't recognize Tony Stark?
Is that Iron Man?
Technically.
You're dead. So how long has it been since the attack?
What happened to him?
Life. I built him. I take care of him. I'll fix him.
Like a mechanic.
I believe he actually did make a stealth suit eventually. He knows about that kind of stuff.
I got just the thing. This is a pinata for a cricket. I'm kidding, it's a very powerful weapon.
Put it away from the cricket.
It discourages bullying. Non lethal, just to cover one's ass. Deal? Deal? What do you say?
Deal.
Deal? What's your name?
Harley. And you're.
Tell me. You know what keeps going through my head? Where's my sandwich?
I'm not sure about this, but I think that Harley Keener is actually Iron Lad in the comics. I don't remember his name right now, but like I said, I think. In any case, there's no reason it shouldn't be Harley Keener. By the way, a few years ago, a lot of people thought that this guy, Harley Keener, was actually Peter Parker. Some people even thought it was the kid from the Stark Expo, but that was later retcon. It was actually Peter Parker.
I think that my boss is working for the Mandarin.
And you chose not to tell her that?
I don't want to talk about it. I suggest we get ourselves someplace safe.
Away from here.
Your boss works for the Mandarin, you think? But Tony says you're a botanist. Not figure. That's why they left. 40 out of a privately funded think tank, but sure, you can call me a bot. This boss of yours, does he have a name? Yeah, Aldrich Killian.
I know that name. Surprise, surprise! They didn't really let him use real guns, did they? So, later, we've learned that he's actually been staying in that place this whole time. So where exactly did they bring him from? And if they're all in on that joke, then what's with all the super secrecy and they'll make eye contact and then blah blah blah. Again.
What are we waiting for?
A very terrible, terrible plot twist. Shut up already.
What's the official story here? What happened?
I guess this guy named Chad Davis used to live one of the docks. He won a bunch of medals in the army. One day, folks said he went crazy and made, a bomb. Then he blew himself up right here.
That's kind of true.
Yeah.
And why are there only six shadows? No, it's five shadows.
Six dead. Only five shadows.
Yeah, but people said these shadows are like the mark of souls going to heaven. Except the bomb guy. Who went to hell and kind of he didn't get a shadow. That's why there's only five.
Did you buy that?
Does it?
You know what this crater reminds me of?
No idea.
The worm
here.
A giant wormhole in New York. Does it remind you?
That's manipulative. I don't want to talk about it.
They're coming back. Aliens?
Maybe. Can you stop? Remember when I told you that I have an anxiety issue?
Does this subject make you edgy?
Yeah, a little bit. Can I just kept my reference?
Yes!
Stop doing that, I swear you're gonna freak me out. Oh man, you did it, didn't you? You happy now?
What did I say? Hey, what up?
Yeah, dead end street.
What the hell is that?
This movie came out in May, by the way. How is it a Christmas movie? I have no idea. Very much. Don't I know you? Thanks.
Clearly you're waiting for someone else. It's supposed to be empty here.
Mia! MIA, that's missing in action. Or is it? No, sorry. Hello again. Why did she bring handcuffs?
Yes, ma'am, it is. You are.
Homeland Security. We good here?
No, we're not good. I need a little more information than that.
Well, I think it's a little above your pay grade, Sheriff.
Yeah, well, why don't you get on the horn in Nashville and upgrade me?
Alright, you know what? I was hoping to do this the smart way, but,
I guess there is no smart way. Burn! Oh. Oh, you again. You didn't see. Yeah, very much.
Watch this.
Very crazy. Fairy, his hands are cuffed. Hey, lady, I fought aliens, by the way. Well, that's one way to get rid of that. And again, this shows you just how smart Tony Stark is. He's basically MacGyver. He's using whatever he's got at his disposal to his advantage. Horrible way to die. Melty, melty, melty! Oh, he can talk. Oh, yeah, that. Westworld. So did he actually bring it with him? And he didn't use it until now? What the hell? Oh, it was a one-off. Yeah, he shouldn't be using his leg right now. At least of all jumping like that. Car keys.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
What the? Me saving your life.
Yeah, A, save you first. B, thanks, sort of. And C, if you do someone a solid, don't be a yutz, right? Just play it cool, otherwise you come off grandiose.
Oh, look, you can talk! Do you even know the number?
We're done here. Move out of the way, I'm gonna run you over. Bye, kid.
Didn't you just say you need him? To guard the suit?
I'm sorry, kid. You did good.
So now you're just gonna leave me here? With my dad?
Yeah. Heh. Wait, you're guilt tripping me, aren't you?
I'm cool.
I can tell. You know how I can tell?
Because we're connected! Alright. Yeah, I wish the end of it. That's a bummer. I'm still thirsty. Yeah, nobody cares about that. Oh, is that suddenly a surprise to you guys? It's been happening for months. Wait a minute, they showed us that they were about to record like half an hour ago. And only now they decided to move forward with it?
Mr. President.
Only two lessons remain.
I intend to finish this before Christmas morning. Meet Thomas Richards. Good strong name, good strong job. Thomas here is an accountant for the Roxxon Oil Corporation.
I love that they're using the name Roxxon as one of the main side villains in the MCU. He's trying to be a good president.
Bouncing
the signal off of that. But still, again, Ben Kingsley is such a good actor. And he did such a good job as the Mandarin. Why did you have to ruin it? This has got to be my most emotional commentary yet. And yes, by the way, in case you didn't notice that already. Where is the Mandarin? Tony Stark can do that because he's Tony Stark. You didn't recognize the voice? By the way, here's a shocker. Iron Patriot in the comics wasn't actually a War Machine. It was... Sorry, I don't know why I froze there. It was Norman freaking Osborn. Right? The Green Goblin is the Iron Patriot in the comics. Just seriously, look it up. Stanley! Again, you know, typical Shane Blackness.
Tony Stark is in my van.
No, sir.
I know you were still alive. Wow.
Can I just say, sir?
Yeah.
I'm your biggest fan.
Okay, first, is this your van? Is anyone else going to come in?
No, just us.
Which man?
Gary.
I think he's also a character from the comics. I'm not sure. I get really confused, Mickey.
I don't know if you can tell, but I had, like, pattern my whole look after you. My hair's a little... It's not right, because there's no product in it.
Right.
I don't want to make things awkward for you, but I do have to show you...
Boom!
Spag, Scott Bale. I'm sorry, is that me?
Yeah. It's, I had them do it off a doll that I made, so it's not like it's off a picture.
Creepy.
I don't want to clip your wings here. We're both a little overexcited. I got an issue. I'm chasing bad guys. Trying to grapple with some hardcore data files. I don't have enough juice. I need you to jump on the roof. Right? Recalibrate the ISDNs.
He's still wearing that stupid watch. Machine 68. It's not. I think it's the year that War Machine was introduced. It could be Don Cheadle's birthday or Rhodes' birthday in the movie. I also thought it was a pretty good idea to use the extremist, you know, heal wounded soldiers. I mean, in a universe where you don't have the Spider-Man Venom symbiote to create something like Agent Venom or something. It was a pretty good idea.
What happened? built rockets for the Nazis. Idealistic, run up on brawn, dreamed of space travel. Stargazed.
Hmm. Yeah, I think I heard about that somewhere.
The rocket performed perfectly. Just landed on the wrong planet. See, we all begin wide-eyed, pure science. And then the ego steps in, obsession.
Isn't that how it always works? Again, it would have been a completely different movie if she ended up being the Mandarin and not you know who. Cliche! Especially in this scene.
This is the 14 Blue Zero, sending coordinates for suspected Mandarin broadcast point of origin. Copy.
Nobody move.
We're just sewing clothes.
Support Blue Zero. Unless the Mandarin's next attack on the U.S. involves cheaply made sportswear, I think you messed up again.
Oh, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Melty, melty, melty. What the? That's Rebecca Marder from Once Upon a Time. I did not realize she was in this movie. Wow. So that's her, Sebastian Stan, and Josh Dallas. Wow. Cranberry. Didn't happen now. Oh, what is Miami?
Go ahead and say Miami, Florida.
Okay, first things first, need the armor. Where are we at with it?
It's not charging.
What do you mean it's not charging?
Actually, sir, it is charging. But the power source is questionable. It may not succeed to revitalizing the Mark 42.
What's questionable about electricity? Alright, it's my suit. And then
And there he goes again.
Are you planning another attack? I didn't even mention New York.
Right, and then you just said it by name, while denying having said it.
Okay, Just breathe. Really, just breathe. You're a mechanic, right?
Mechanic something. I can build.
Okay.
How much money does he have, by the way? Or does he remember the number of his credit card? Again, once again, this shows you just how incredibly smart Tony Stark is. He's a freaking genius. He makes weapons out of literally nothing. And that's one of the things this movie does so well. It's Tony Stark without the Iron Man suit. It's brilliant. And of course, we saw him working out at the first act of the movie, so we know he can do these kind of stunts. Whee! Shut up. And he has learned a few moves since, you know, sparring with a certain Asgardian Thunder God, sorry. Kaboof! Merry Christmas! Boom! Yeah, our bullets.
Why is it so hot in here? I told you to put it at 68.
My fault again. Let me tell you something, sweetheart. I am not your personal enemy.
Buzz! There's the set. Was that green screen? Did they miss some of the... Or was it part of the set? That's a way to save money, by the way. Have it be filmed on an actual set. Hello, ladies. And he's in the bathroom. And that's when this movie lost me.
That's me.
Hookers.
Did you know that fortune cookies aren't even Chinese? They're made by
American. I think it's his real accent, by the way.
Japanese recipe. Hey.
Hello?
Bloody hell. You want something? Take it. Although the guns are all fake because those wankers wouldn't trust me with the real ones.
I thought so. But he's not here. His hip is not here. It's funny, but I still hate the twist. I was so shocked when it happened. But they were pretty. The other way.
My name's Trevor. Trevor Slattery.
What are you? What are you, decoy? You're a double, right?
What am I going to study? Absolutely not.
I love the outfit, by the way. On the stand.
Just about the Mandarin.
The Mandarin. Drugs. No two ways about it.
In the street,
ugh.
They approached me about the role, and then
because he looks pretty good.
They gave me things.
That's what he said.
Hey. Kill him?
terror threat.
Yes! Yes!
I think I had a hole in my...
The pathology of a serial killer. The manipulation of Western...
This just shows you how wonderful of an actor Sir Bings Kingsley is. Nobody dies. People die.
Bleh. Okay, Joe. What'd you tell him?
Nothing.
I didn't tell him anything.
Nothing.
No. Yeah. Should have pressed the panic button. Well, a panic, but then I handled it.
Oh. Hello again, by the way. Military bed. I used to sleep on those a lot.
Muhahaha! Like old times, huh?
One could think that she really was the Mandarin.
Wasn't my idea.
Okay, so you took Killian's card.
I took his money.
And here you are, 13 years later, in a dungeon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a dungeon. You don't say. I met a god.
Practically stable.
I'm telling you, it isn't. I'm on the street. They're going bang. They're painting the walls, Maya. You're kidding yourself.
Help me fix it.
You know who I am.
Huh.
Yes.
I remember the night, not the morning. Is this what you've been chasing around?
You don't remember?
I can't help you. You set up a moral psychology.
Used to
have ideals. Want to help people. Now we got you. I get to wake up every morning with someone who
mostly likes me.
Still has their soul. Get me out of here.
Those springs are reminding me a lot of the military bed I used to sleep on. Heard that before.
Gets the cheese.
I'm still pissed off about the Switzerland thing, are
you? How can I be pissed at you, Tony? I'm here to thank you. You gave me the greatest gift that anybody's ever given me. Desperation. If you think back to Switzerland, you said you'd meet me on the rooftop, right? Well, for the first 20 minutes, I actually thought you'd show up. The next hour, I considered taking that one step.
Yeah, I've been there. The man pulling the strings.
Yeah, Sir Lawrence Olivier. I know he's over the top sometimes. It's not entirely my fault. He has a he's a stage actor. They say his leader was the toast of Croydon, whoever that is. Anyway, the point is, ever since that big dude with the hammer fell out of the sky, subtlety's kind of had its day.
Yeah, I met him.
What's next for you in your world? Well, I wanted to repay you the self-same gift that you so graciously imparted to me.
And his gun rings as well. Just saying!
Desperation. Now this is live. I'm not sure if you can tell. But at this moment, the body is trying to decide whether to accept Extremis or just give up. And if it gives up, I have to
You know
say,
what happens.
The detonation is quite spectacular. But until that point, it's really just a lot of pain.
Let him go! Let him go!
I said let him go!
What is that?
1200 cc's, a dose half of this size, I'm dead.
It's times like this my temper is tested somewhat. I give you an injector.
I die, Killian. What happens to your soldiers? What happens to your product?
We're not doing this, okay?
What happens to you? What happens if you go too hot?
So are those two together? Well, that was pointless.
The good news is, the high level position has just been vacated.
For who?
You are a maniac.
It was a completely pointless death. Wasn't it?
Afternoon, gentlemen. Hello, Colonel. Step aside.
All right. Melty, melty, melty. Eventually. This is phase two. It's ready.
Careful there. It's a limited edition. Hey, Ponytail Express. What's the mileage count between Tennessee and Miami?
832 miles.
Very nice.
I'm good like that.
There's a button. Very simple.
Okay, that wasn't mine to give away. That belongs to my friend's sister. And that's why I'm going to kill you first.
What are you going to do to me?
You'll see.
You're zip-tied to a bed.
This.
That. Shazam! Actually, reused this same concept in Thor Ragnarok, if you remember. You gotta draw the first punch! And after that, he can breathe fire now!
Fire?
I think it's the first time Rhodey's actually been exposed to something as mad as this. Because he completely missed the Avengers thing. Veterans who lost their limbs?
And a puddle of blood on the ground. 5, 4, 3, come on! 2!
He didn't.
How did we get this ship?
Really?
Give you a chance to escape.
Think of the mileage.
Tie yourself to those chairs. I'll let you live. In 5, 4, bang! Oh, you should be gone by now. You should already be gone.
It's just stolen. They should have shot him by now. Oh, good killing, Chris. Kick!
Where's the rest?
I'm curious to know how these two parts actually made it all the way through. The score though. Whee! Again, the action scenes are magnificent. It's just the thing. It turns out it wasn't the real Mandarin the whole time. You're looking at a fake. She's oof. She's oof? What? Oh! Smash!
Honestly, I hate working here. They are so weird.
Eventually. And that's again.
Not the face.
Not the face.
Oh, it's good to be back. Hello, by the way. Oh, hello, sir.
They've taken the roadie. They kept him alive for some reason.
Tony, Brody, tell me that was you in the suit.
No.
You got yours?
Kind of.
Be in house fast as you can.
Somebody like you need.
Oh, hello there.
Get out!
How many of those does he have? I was drinking when I fell asleep.
What have you come at? You make a move, I'll break your face.
I never thought people would be hurt. Lie to me.
This is the
you didn't want to know.
It's embarrassing. Hi, Trevor. Trevor's Patrick. It's true. I know I'm shorter in person, a bit smaller. Everyone says that. But hey, if you're here to arrest me, there's some people I'd like to rule on.
Here's how it works, Middle Street. You tell him where
Middle Street.
To stop doing it.
This.
I'm
still watching the game. Ole, 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 ole.
So, what are we gonna do? We don't have any transport.
Hey,
what?
Ringo, didn't you say something about a lovely speedboat?
Oh, that.
She's right about the location. We're 20 minutes from where Pepper is.
But they also have to figure out this vice president thing, right?
Oh, what am I calling right now?
Oh, that's the vice president.
They're supposed to be dead.
You're about to be drawn into the Mandarin campaign. We gotta get you somewhere safe as soon as possible.
Mr. Stark, I'm about to eat honey roast ham surrounded by the agency's finest presidency on Air Force One with Colonel Rhodes. I think we're good here.
Sir, this is Colonel Rhodes.
They're using the Iron Patriot as a Trojan horse. They're gonna take out the president somehow. We have to immediately alert that plane.
Okay, I'm on an island security. Lock it down. If need be, they can have F-22s in the air in 30 seconds.
Thank you, Colonel. Rhodes and Stark out.
Yeah. Surprise, surprise! The vice president is actually also in league with the bad guys. Of course, later we found out that he was actually working for Hydra. And that, you know, they offered him the extremist to heal his daughter. And how exactly did he learn to control this stuff? But
everything all right, Colonel?
speed! Go away! I can do this now. Shut up. Is that Ron Perlman? Yeah, because that's gonna help you. Because Google Earth technology has greatly improved. I got you. And he blew a hole in him. Pretty sure these guys should be dead by now, but... Yeesh. Okay. But we have to get creative again. Because that's another thing this movie does so well. How Tony Stark thinks. So, twist! Full fast this! Oh. Come here! So it turns out they were about to land in water as well, so kind of cushions the fall, I guess. And he's still dropping them in the water. It's not like put them on dry land or anything.
That came out of nowhere.
Wow. Give me some good news, man. I think they all made it.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, but I missed the president. You couldn't save the president with the suit. How are we going to save Pepper with nothing?
Say, Jarvis, is it that time?
The house party protocol.
The house party protocol! I love the house party protocol! The best thing about this movie. And we saw what's inside that thing earlier. Look, a lot of strangely familiar lights inside.
Hi.
Hi. Doesn't need him to help him.
Having you here is not just to motivate Tony Stark. It's actually more embarrassing than that. You're here as my
trophy.
Kinda. Yeah.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, bro. So they learn how to remote control it. Norco! A rock song.
2 years ago.
Tanker. Who is that? Because if you watch the Marvel one-shot, All Hail the King, they pretty much set it up that there really is a real Mandarin out there somewhere, and he's pissed off that they represented him that way. So could this new president be the real Mandarin? I don't know. You gotta watch that one shot, by the way. Look up Marvel one shot, All Hail the King. You won't be disappointed, I guarantee you that. Yeah, not looking at all like Jesus, by the way. I'm pretty sure Nick Fury and Captain America would probably be on that thing by now. Not, you know, Tony Stark without his suit. That's one of the main problems that these movies ran into after the Avengers. It was like, whenever something major happened, where are the Avengers? Where's S.H.I.E.L.D.? Where's this and that? Well, sometimes these characters just handle these things alone. Of course, after, after Age of Ultron, all these other movies became a little bit more connected with each other, and characters started showing up in other characters' movies. They're coming. All 30 plus armors. That's the Heartbreaker, Mark 13, the Red Snapper. I recognize a bunch of these. Don't remember this guy. Light him up! That's Bones, Mark 40. And that's why they call him Bones, by the way. And they're still ripping them apart. Boom! Yeah, that's Igor. Mark 32, I believe. Very early, early design for, the Hulkbuster armor. Yep, that's Red Snapper, and that's the Heartbreaker. Whoosh! So is Jarvis basically controlling all these?
Where's timing? Oh yeah, that's awesome. Give me a suit of tip. Oh, I'm sorry, they're only coded to me. What's that mean? I got you covered.
That's the Silver Centurion.
Can I give you a lift?
And that's the Heartbreaker. Silver Centurion is also from the comics, by the way. Yeah, that's the drilling one. I can't remember the number or the name. I really hope you guys can hear me, by the way. I'll just put this thing over here.
See what happens when you hang out with my ex-girlfriends.
Hello, my dear.
Is this guy bothering you?
Melty, melty, melty. Or is it just you? By the way, there's a thing in these Phase 2 movies, that's the movies between Iron Man 3 and Ant-Man. All these movies had one of the characters, at least one of the characters, lose an arm. That was their little tribute to Star Wars, you know, The Empire Strikes Back, since Luke Skywalker lost his arm in that movie. So, Killian is the first character to lose his arm in this trend. Any suit! Whee! Look. Yeah, we get it! I'm pretty sure these bullets don't really work on them. Get ready, Rhodes, because things are about to get a lot weirder in the next few movies. Whee! Yeah, there's no way he survived that. Kaboom! Whee! There's no way you survived that again.
Look
Ouch.
President is secure, Tony. I'm clearing the area. Nice work. Ready, sir? What do you mean,
Rich? Whee! Yeah, her body should be broken by now. So, very broken. Don't make promises you can't keep! Burn. Again, another... Well, I'll see that if I leave. Look at my new arm!
Shane, I would have caught
her. Yeah, yeah. No way! Oh, I forgot what this suit is called. There's a special guidebook of all the suits, which I don't have at the moment. Whee! Peace! Oh, that's the Jiminy! No. Is it? The spacesuit. No, that's not it. I believe the Jiminy's white with a yellow face plate. Eesh! Well, that's clever and useful. Oh! Lots and lots of thrust. Oh. More of a match for him. Eject! How many suits are left?
Mark 42 in now.
Oh, dear. Oh, about time.
The prodigal son returns.
Buzz, 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 buzz. Yeah.
Whatever. You really didn't serve it, Tony. So close to having her. Perfect.
She already was.
Wait, hold on. You're right. I don't deserve her. Here's where you're wrong. She was already perfect.
This is blah 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 blah. Pizzuts! Weeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeeee It's the one with the thrusters again, I believe. So does that count for destroying something when you leave certain parts still there? No head inside. Then again, you could always regenerate. But a very symbolic moment, him looking at the burning Iron Man helmet, reflecting on himself. Yeesh. I am the Mandarin! Yeah, thanks for that. And another case of fake killing. This time with Pepper. Oh, really? That's a first. Huh. I'm a badass now! Because Shane Black's directing this movie! Pizza! Tony's done that several times.
Honey?
Man, she's skinny. He's like Plato.
That was really violent.
So, does that mean that her bra and pants are fire resistant? There we go. The mechanic. The clean slate protocol.
Screw it, it's Christmas. Yes. Yes.
I never understood what was the point of this. Boom. I mean, it's a beautiful moment, but you know, is this of you destroying everything that makes him Iron Man? So, was all that for nothing? How did they find out about him, though?
We create our own demons.
My fans!
As promised, I got Pepper sorted out.
Wouldn't it be funny if Doctor Strange was operating on him?
Why stop there? Of course, there are people who say progress is dangerous. But I'll bet none of those idiots ever had to live with a chest full of shrapnel. And now...
Again, he's taking away the thing that makes him who he is.
Blocking the TV.
And he's still checking for a security badge. And guess who? So does this kid even have parents? Or a sister? Oh yeah, guess what? Oh, he gave him a car too? Potato Gun Mark II. Your pal the mechanic. So we did manage to salvage that watch, I see. I wonder where does he live now after this? But that's bloating!
So if I were to wrap this up tied with a bow, whatever, I guess I'd say my armor. It was never a distraction or a hobby. It was a cocoon.
To what?
And now, I'm a changed man.
E-tron. I wonder. Tricks and toys.
We can't do it.
I am Iron Man. By the way, did you notice? No AC/DC in this movie, by the way. Kevin Feige, obviously. And we're getting this nice little montage of all the cool Iron Man action shots. From all three Iron Man movies. Was that Captain America there? I guess this really puts a nice bow on it. As a nice, you know, conclusion to the Iron Man trilogy. They weren't really thinking of Iron Man 4 at the time. Ooh, butts. Robert Downey Jr., Gwyneth Paltrow, Don Cheadle, Guy Pearce, Rebecca Hall, Stephanie Zosak, James Badge Dale, William Sadler, Miguel Ferrer, with Jon Favreau and Sir Ben Kingsley, Bill Dickey, Ty Simpkins. Marvel Studios presents in association with Paramount Pictures and DMG Entertainment. A Marvel Studios production. Iron Man 3. So now all we have to do is just bide our time till, you know, the post-credits scene. Again, you gotta admit, it was a pretty nice montage. There she is, Rebecca Marder. Huh. Funny. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. What time is it? Well, I was gonna do Thor the Dark World after this, but no. I'm wiped out. Tomorrow, I guess. Maybe we can finally get to do this during the daytime, and I won't have to rely on this stupid lamp. Well, I'm so sorry about that. That's a very long time. 6 more minutes. A lot of digital effects, people, on this movie. Wow! It's still going! Wow! What the hell? Did you see that? That's what I keep looking at these credits for. Man! Wow! There's another one. Shorter. Much, much shorter. Significantly shorter. Da 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 I'm blue, da 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 da. Marvel music. Oh, Christmas tree. Special thanks to Joss Whedon and Jeremy Lecter. Fan Benji. Where's the approved number 48,254?
Cheryl, my intimate thoughts and experiences with someone who just cuts the weight of it in half. You know, it's like a snake swallowing its own tail when it comes full circle. And the fact that you've been able to help me process.
What?
Now that I think about it, oh god, my original world. 1983, right? I'm 14 years old, I still have a name. That was weird.
Huh? Okay, so, clearly, Mark Ruffalo just popped in. Oh, look, Tony Stark will return. No mention of Iron Man, though. Weird. But, Mark Ruffalo clearly showed up to play. Playing Bruce Banner again. Again, this wasn't really a crucial scene for the rest of the plot of the French. No, it was just a funny tag at the end, which it's nice every once in a while to get, you know? So, I hope you enjoyed this very emotional commentary for Iron Man 3. And I hope I didn't lose you along the way, just like Tony lost his audience. But for now, let's just call it a night.